Hey everyone, welcome. It's Vaughn, the founder of Ballroom Mastery. It's awesome to have you here. Today I'm going to help you to develop the way that you should count to the waltz. In my studio, we run one of the largest studios in the city, and we've had hundreds and hundreds of couples and thousands of people come to the studio now after almost 10 years of running a professional level studio. And the biggest problem I find that we all face, whether you're a beginner, whether you're an advanced dancer, right up to the top echelon, is musicality. And it's not musicality in and of itself that we're trying to develop from the beginning, but it's something that we're all aware of. I mean, hey, dancing is music made visible. So if we're not on time, we're in a bit of trouble, right? Like we've got to figure out what that gap is. Now, even if we're on time, how do we develop the rhythm and feel the music in our body and then show that we feel the music in our body? You know, we don't want to have a disconnect. Have you ever felt that where it's like you feel the beat, not just the instruments, but you actually feel the music. Then when you go to step out and dance, it's like, it just like dies and you don't know what to do. Well, we have other videos around that you'll be able to look at to find the cause of that problem, such as balance or technique or other things that you have to develop in your body. But today's lesson is specifically on the waltz music. So I'll give a brief introduction to music that we don't have to have. Look, we don't have to have the highest level of musical knowledge. Like we don't need to be grade 8 piano players or violin concerto players, right? But we need to have a very base level understanding to really enhance the way we develop and work with the music in the waltz. Personally, my biggest struggle was understanding how to not only count to music, but sync my body with the music, to sync and dance on time. For me, it felt like forever. Like Allison would be, who's my partner and now wife, she would always count me in because she had no problem. So if you're like me, I had so much problem with hearing the music properly and really getting into timing. So this lesson really helped me and I really hope it helps you. So let's get into it. First thing to understand about dancing, music, is that we have a time signature. What does that mean? It means how many beats are in a bar. So if we're looking at waltz, we know it's 3/4 time. So the tempo is the speed of the music at which it plays. In waltz, typically, it's what we refer to as 28. I think it can sometimes go a little higher to like 30 bars, but about 28 to 30 bars a minute. So BPM means bars per minute. It doesn't mean beats per minute like in dance music, right? So bars per minute. So again, coming back, what's a bar? Well, we look at, say, sheet music. Hopefully you can see this a little bit. Essentially, imagine that's one beat, one beat, one beat, right? One, two, three. Another one, one, two, three. Another one, one, two, three. This is the counter waltz, one, two, three. Okay, so we know there's three beats in a bar. Waltz has three counts. And of course, we have syncopations like ands that we could put in. So one, two, and three, for example. But we're not too worried about that today. So essentially, our base time for the waltz is one, two, three. Meaning that we can count to the music, which I'll do in a moment with you, and we can count one, two, three, and be right on beat, have our feet working with that, and voila, we'll dance very well. What we want to aim to do is to dance something called phrased timing. Okay, so this gets a little bit more complicated, but if you review this lesson again, it will help you a lot. Before we begin, let's count some music together, right? We'll go. Two, three, one, two, three. One, two, three. You can hear the music building up. Now it goes one, two, three. One, two, three. Right, one. One is the strongest beat, it's the accent. One, two, three. 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 Okay, so you feel how that works? All right, that's base time. So I was, of course, accenting the one because that's sort of the strongest beat, meaning, you know, it's our downswing and we're coming up at the end of one in the waltz. But essentially, that timing, one, two, three, you can hear quite clearly if you're using what I call as beginner music, where it's like a very strong beat. It's not too soft and flowy. You can hear it very strongly in the music. Our goal at first is to get our steps in time with that, as we already know. But what do we ultimately want to do? We want to dance to phrased music. Let's explain what this means. Well, let's start by counting the music differently. I like the idea of singing your counts. Let's look at this. One of the mistakes that I find people come in is I say, count the music for me. We spend a good time with that. And they'll count like this. One, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, you know, or it'll be one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, like it'll be off time, it'll be out of sync and it won't be melodic. So if we sing our counts, we're gonna have a huge, huge improvement in the way we dance. My coach used to always say to me, if you count like a mouse, you're gonna dance like a mouse. I'm like, oh, I like that. I don't know what that means, but that sounds interesting. Now I understand what it means. If you count like this, one, two, three, one, two. You're like, you're not gonna dance very well. So you must count how you wish to dance. So one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three. You can hear the color in my voice, right? You can hear the inflection, the change of the pitch. That's how you should count to start with. So if nothing else lands today, go back into your dancing, count your routine out as you want it to dance. Is a part of your dancing softer? Is a part of your dancing stronger? Is it faster or more progressive, or is it stopping? However the dance or the routine is structured and the choreography is structured, whatever that base time is, change the way in which you are counting the music and you might find a huge difference instantly. In fact, I know you will if you just try it out. But let's go a little deeper now. Let's understand phrase timing. So for example, let's take this away just for the moment, and I'm gonna write out, we know that waltz is one, two, three in terms of count. We also know that there's three beats per bar. There's essentially eight bars in waltz before the music sort of recycles, if you will. It's probably the easiest way to explain it. So what does this mean? Well, let's look at the waltzes. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Okay, awesome. Now I'm lost. What the hell does that mean? Well, stay with me. Instead of counting one, two, three, we count one, two, three, two, two, three, three, two, three, four, two, three, five, two, three, six, two, three, seven, two, three. What's the last one? Eight, two, three. That's phrased, okay? What does that mean? Let's put it into practice with the music so I can exemplify it first and then we'll go into it. Here we go. You can hear there's an introduction. Four, two, three. One, two, three. Two, two, three. Three, two, three. Four, two, three. Five, two, three. Six, two, three. Seven, two, three. Eight, two, three. Phrase timing. Now, the music will kick in. Next time we do it, you'll hear the music kick over and it'll go back into either a new level of music or it'll just drop back. Like it's like a crescendo and it goes down. Outside of that, we don't need to get too more technical with the music right now. We just need to understand that there's a phrased timing we can use. And when we can hear that in the music, we will be in sync with the music far more than just picking any number one, two, three and finding anyone at any bar and just going. So what does this mean for us practically? What it means is that in your waltz routine, you want to start your dancing on bars one, three, five, seven, or eight. Okay, so when you're counting the music, not your preparation step, not your wind up, none of that's starting on the preceding bar. You want to start your choreography, like let's say the natural spin turn in the waltz. You want to start that one, two, three, and then hit the spin action or the spin pivot of it on two, two, three. And when you do that, you'll find your routine will flow very well to the music, and most choreography should be structured in a way where you're not ever just dancing across and through everything. You're trying to hit, you know, bar five, hit bar eight, make your choreography sort of come, you know, to a point like a good sentence structure or a paragraph. Not that I can write, I suck with grammar, right? So don't judge me on that. But at least with dancing, you know, we try to do this. We aim to get our beats and bars right so we get our movement happening on phrase and we want to come out. So for example, if we do like an over sway and we come out, that's bar eight, we want to come out. So we can take off on one. That's a nice way of sort of syncing to the music and making it look like our choreography is actually matched to the music, even if it's a standard routine, right? So I hope this helps you. Let's try counting this together. We go like this. So you can hear it. Three. Now four, two, three. One, two, three. Two, two, three. Three, two, three. Four, two. Five, two, three, six, two, three, seven, two, three, eight. Listen. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, here it comes, 8, 1. Ah, awesome, right? So can you see by counting like that, you can start to appreciate the music on a different level. It's not just like, oh my God, where's the one, right? You start to really get into it. I think that's the biggest encouragement I can give you, because I did not do this. In fact, I sucked when I first started counting like this. Oh, I can remember all sorts of pain having to stand there and just try to count to the music, let alone counting 1, 2, 3, 2, 2, 3, 3, 3, 3. I couldn't even say that, right? So I'm encouraging you, use me as, you know, if I can do it, you can do it, but you have to be persistent and you need a bit of guidance, right? Like, so, you know, feel free to send me a video of you counting and I'll have a look at it, but let me know if this helps you, because it helped me, but it took me a fair bit of understanding. I had to recycle and redo and go through these lessons a lot. And most importantly, experiment, right? You gotta go and do it wrong a lot and then keep reiterating, keep trying. One day the music just sinks. And then you can go from what I call the keyboard bashing music, where it's just like 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, to like real super soft flowing songs like cinematic songs and music, which have like no strong beat. They're like wind, you know, soft silk floating on the wind type songs where it's just, wow, where's the beat? But all of a sudden you can start to hear it because your body has been so attuned to working in harmony with the waltz. You can hear it, just sort of comes to you. So I encourage you, practice, not perfectly, but aim for practicing perfectly, but practice deliberately. Go back into what you're doing and really focus on the music like this, because it will change the way you dance. Now, just to wrap up how we've done this, you are to count as you want to dance. Not like a mouse, but the way you want to dance. And you got to count confidently. I always make students in my class count out loud, especially the ones that don't want to count out loud in front of everyone. I make them count. Why? Because it made me better, it'll make you better. So challenge yourself, count out loud, count with your partner, count solo, keep counting, count as you want to dance, and of course, count with phrasing, and then let me know how you go. This is Vaughn. I appreciate you coming today. Subscribe to the channel, and let me know if you'd like more of this. And let's master the art of ballroom dancing together. Thank you.